Hey guys, it's Kevin. I already have a video about how to uncasing the XP-15000 and how to take the printhead out. So this video I'm going to focus on replacing the printhead cables. If you need a video from start, just click above and it's going to show you how to uncase it. Okay, here's Abby.
Hey guys, it's Abby. So we're going to start by taking out the printhead. There should be screws. We didn't have screws in our test printer here. I was able to lift it out. I had to push a little bit on the side FFC cables to make sure that it was flat against the carriage to help lift out the printhead. But once I did that, I was able to lift it up out and pull the two FFC cables that lead to the back and under the printhead there. So we have the two large FFC cables detached from the printhead, and there is this plastic guard on the outside of the right side of the carriage to hold the FFC cables in place together. So I'm using my fingernail to pick at the side just to pop it off of the carriage. I believe there was double-sided tape that was holding it on there, so you can just pull that double-sided tape off to release it from the carriage holding the FFC cables tight down to it. And then at that point, I was able to take the large FFC cables and just pull slightly to take off the double-sided tape that holds it going around almost that front perimeter of the carriage inside. It doesn't go around that top back perimeter, but it goes around the front three sides of the carriage. So I took off the double-sided tape for that, and then we're going to work on taking this side clip off towards the front on the right. And here I have it up close in my hand, and I'll show you how it works. So it looks almost like a belt buckle, and you can use a little toothpick or dentist pick to pull up on that buckle part, and then you pull it to the side where I'm showing you here. There's these tabs that lock into place, so when you lift up on that buckle part and push to the side, it should release and snap off of the carriage, and that will release the FFC cables that buckle holds onto. Okay, and from here we're just going to slowly work out the cables. There is a smaller FFC cable that stays in there, and at this point I just needed to fold the small pins towards the FFC cables, twist, like fold the pins inside a little bit. As you can see, I fold them and that pinches it shut for me to be able to pull it out through the small slot in the carriage. Alright. And so now I'm just going to work the FFC cable out of the plastic guard. So again, I believe that there is double-sided tape that was possibly holding the two large FFC cables to that smaller FFC cable. So if you work on slowly pulling apart that double-sided tape, then you can work out the large FFC cables again through the plastic guard. Once the large FFC cables are out, then that plastic guard is free. Put it off to the side and don't lose it. Same thing with that small buckle clip that I was showing you that holds the FFC cables to the carriage. Put those to the side. You'll use them again later when you put new FFC cables back into place. Alright, so we're going to look at it a bit from a different angle, and I found that it would be easier to pull the FFC cables out from a different way. So now we're working on detaching a bit of the cables from the main board so we can pull it out that way instead, because the large side of the FFC cables leading to the printhead was too big to go through the second plastic guard in the middle behind the LCD panel area. We need to try to find the three middle cables that work with this FFC cable and lead into the main board that we want to work out, because there's two smaller FFC cables that lead around, one in the front and one on the back of these three FFC cables. We're trying not to pull those ones out, just work out these three middle FFC cables here. This is that second plastic guard that doesn't come out, but also is held down by a bit of double-sided tape. So you can pull a bit of the double-sided tape off, but I was not able to find a way to pull it off completely. I also didn't want to risk just trying to rip it off because I didn't know if I'd be able to find a way to put it back on completely. Here it comes into the middle part, and I'll put it over to the side. All right. Here you see that there is an iron core that is holding the FFC cables in place and a piece of tape. I had to lift up that piece of tape to loosen on the FFC cables, and now there's the main board at the bottom. So I'm just taking off the FFC cables that lead to the main board so I can find the ones that are going to that iron core. I took off that one FFC cable and I saw that it didn't lead to the iron core, so I put it over the top of the LCD panel so it'd be out of my way. You have to find where the double-sided tape is connecting all of these FFC cables, and then take that double-sided tape apart and slowly work out the FFC cables through that iron core. I'm spreading them apart now. As you see, there's 1, 2, 3, and I think 4 cables here, but that fourth one I don't really need. So I move the iron core back, take apart the double-sided tape, and pull the FFC cables that I can see that leading through to the FFC. You don't want to force anything if it isn't working, because you don't want to rip the sides of the cables or tear the cables in it anyways, because that could also ruin them further. Okay, so we got our three main FFC cables disconnected, and at this point we're gonna pull them out towards the print head because it's easier to get these smaller individual FFC cables one by one out than going the other way. I put the other FFC cables that don't go to the print head back into that iron core, just so I don't lose my spot whenever I want to try to put cables back in. The three FFC cables leading to the print head go in between those. I will pull out the FFC cables that we detached towards the home position of the carriage, because way it's easier to get through that middle plastic guard behind the LCD panel on that rail. That's how we'll take that out. We hope you enjoyed this video. You can visit us at bchtechnologies.com or locally here in Greensboro, North Carolina.